Hey guys, welcome back to another CarX tuning video. Today's tune is a little bit different. It's not the standard drift tune that we've been doing. Today we are making a drag tune for the Canny Dude. This tune is really sick. I really, really like it. The truck's pretty quick with it and it does wheelies, so what more can you ask for? If you have a specific vehicle that you want me to find a tune for, be sure to drop it down in the comments below and I will make a video on it. I know some of you probably think I forgot about you, but I promise I didn't. I do have a list. It's just taking me a little bit of time to get around to making them. But the list right now, we have the 350Z, we have a Shadow XTR, I think that's the name of it. If I'm wrong, correct me down in the comments. We have an S15 I didn't make a tune for, and we have the Carrot 2, and there might be a couple more that I'm missing, but I promise I have not forgotten you guys. I do read the comments. It's just taking me a little while to get around to it, but we will, and they're gonna be good tunes for you, I promise. Also guys, don't forget, I do have a Discord server now. Link is in the description. It's kind of small right now and there's not a whole lot going on. There's only about 9 or 10 members, but I do plan on doing interactive content in the future, such as drift challenges, drift series, drift tournaments, championships, stuff like that. And it'd be really cool to integrate you guys into that content. So if you're interested in that, be sure to check that out. Link in the description below. But with that said, let's get into the video and show you this sick drift tune. So to start out, we are actually running the ultimate tune instead of the racing tune for this drag truck. So just head into your dyno stand, and under the suspension, we have our front spring length at 19 centimeters, our rear spring length at 20 centimeters. We have the front spring stiffness at 73, the rear spring stiffness at 102, the front shocks at 40%, the rear shocks at 0%, the front toe at 0.10, our rear toe is at 0.12, our front camber is negative 1.6, probably around negative 1.5 would be okay in that ballpark. It's not too terribly important. I mean, it's important, but not, you know. Anyway, moving on. Rear camber is not, should not be positive. Let's go ahead and move that real quick. Let's just make it neutral. Around neutral would be good. I don't know why it was positive. Anyway, front anti-roll bar at 0, the rear anti-roll bar at 0, caster at 6.5, Ackerman angle at 100%. Our max steering angle is at 50 degrees. Not really important. We're drag racing. We're going straight. As for our wheels, we have 18 inch rims in the front, 25 inch rims in the back. Our front tire width is 255. We're running 325s in the rear. Tire pressure for front and the back is set at 70. Our front wheel adhesion is set at 90%. The rear wheel adhesion is 120%. We have the front wheel track at negative 15 and the rear base at negative 15. And both front tire profiles, or the front and rear tire profile, is at 70%. Now under the engine tab, we have the engine tune-up maxed out at 5%. Now you want your max torque to come in at the lowest RPM. So we have it set at 4,165. We have our rev limiter set at 8,800. The turbocharger is turned on and the boost pressure is turned all the way up. Now as for our transmission, our diff lock rate is 0.34. The final drive is 4.24. First gear, 3.82. Second gear, 2.13. Third gear is 1.70. Fourth, 1.44. Fifth, 1.22. And sixth at 0.99. Now for our brakes, our brake torque is all the way up. Our brake bias is all the way up. Our ABS is turned on and launch control is turned off. All right, so now that we got the tune, let's take it to the track and see how she does. Thank you. This may not be the fastest tune, but in my opinion, it is certainly the most fun. Thank you guys so much for watching. I really appreciate each and every one of you. And if you enjoyed today's video, do me a favor, hit a like. If you absolutely hated it, go ahead and hit a dislike. It really helps me understand what kind of content you guys actually enjoy and what to post for in the future. Also, if you guys haven't already, please consider hitting that subscribe button with the notification bell turned on so you don't miss out on any content and you have instant notifications when I go live. Furthermore, if you guys are interested in doing more interactive content in the future, such as drag racing competitions or drift competitions, go ahead and check out that Discord link down in the description below. Thank you guys, and I will see you in the next one.